Hi, I'm Mr. Beats. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. Understanding public policies towards externalities can be challenging, but it doesn't have to be. Let's learn about it together. There are two parties in every economic activity, the producer and the consumer. For the most part, economic classes focus on these two parties, but sometimes an economic activity has a consequence for someone else that isn't even involved in the cost, a third party. When this happens, we call it an externality. Some externalities can be good. For instance, if a company switches to using solar panels because it's more cost-effective, it will also have a positive impact on the environment. In this case, the environment is the third party receiving the externality. The government supports positive externalities, in this case by issuing economic subsidies to companies who implement environmentally beneficial policies. But not all externalities are good. Cigarette smoking, for instance, can harm those who are nearby. The government aims to increase positive externalities and limit negative ones. Let's see how. When the government wants to stop a negative externality, they may try regulation. Regulation is a type of public policy that completely limits the externality-causing behavior. Littering is illegal in most places because it harms the environment. It offers little benefit to the person littering, which means it is easier to impose a regulation. Some other common regulatory policies are non-smoking policies and noise regulations at night. The goal of every public policy that uses regulation is to limit negative externalities. A Pigouvian tax is a tax the government levies in order to discourage economic activity without limiting it entirely. Take alcohol, for example, which produces negative externalities like violence and traffic accidents. This leads to some governments, bars, and restaurants placing additional taxes on alcoholic purchases. So what does it look like? Here, we can see that MSC shows the marginal social cost and MSB shows the marginal social benefit. The marginal private benefit, MPB, however, is higher than the MSB. The gray triangle shows the deadweight loss due to negative externality. The government's goal is to lower the MPB so that it aligns with the MSB and offsets the negative externality. To do this, they will place a tax on alcohol, raising the price of alcohol for buyers. Once they do this, the marginal private benefit will go down, getting rid of the negative externality. The MPB line will move down and overlap with the marginal social benefit, so MPB will equal MSB. When this happens, there is no longer a negative externality. As we know, just taxing alcohol won't end violence or traffic accidents, but it's one step the government might take to prevent social harm. While we call this public policy a Pigouvian tax, subsidies can also be used to encourage positive externalities. For instance, let's talk about education. Having an educated society reduces crime and ensures a better future for all. But how can we encourage education? For this example, consider this basic graph. Here we see the price for getting a quality teaching degree and the quantity of quality teachers produced. E star shows the equilibrium where the marginal private cost line is equal to the marginal private benefit. For this reason, the government may subsidize individuals to become teachers by helping pay for their education. A subsidy is some sort of incentive, often money, to increase the likelihood that an actor will do something. In this case, the government will pay for the teacher's education in order for them to become a high-quality teacher. This introduces the marginal social benefit line. When the subsidy is added, more individuals become personally incentivized to become teachers, leading to more quality educators. The subsidy helps in correcting positive externalities and makes MPB equal MSB. E star thus shifts up and becomes E2. The price level of school also shifts up on the y-axis, as does the quantity of quality teachers on the x-axis. Now, the gray area represents the dead weight loss due to the positive externality of higher quality educators. Technically, the subsidy does not improve market efficiency because it creates a positive externality. However, sometimes market efficiency is not the most important thing, as in this situation, where having more quality teachers is the goal. The government is constantly creating policies to help encourage positive externalities and limit negative ones. Can you think of any? We hope this lesson has helped you understand a bit more about public policies toward externalities. If you want to explore these topics more, visit Chegg, where you can find more helpful videos and examples on all things economics. You can also ask for help on your specific problems. We hope to see you back at Chegg soon.